By definition, you would have to discriminate against some groups of people. And again, you see this happening with Asians. So it's not like I'm making this up. This is, the courts have legally decided this. So I'm you could,
and when you say this is happening to Asians, just to clarify, what you mean is that there are actually fewer Asians admitted into top courses in the United States because they're being discriminated against because they would otherwise be too high a proportion of students because
they Kenny Hughes' book has written about this, just An Inconvenient Minority. It's an amazing book that I'd recommend reading. No, it's not that fewer are admitted. It's actually that more are admitted. More Asians are admitted. I say this also as a father of a little girl who's Asian, and I'm also thinking.
Mean fewer are admitted than would be if there were a colorblind admissions policy.
That's correct. Yeah. So they have to raise the standards. So they raise the standards for some racial groups. So basically, it's a type of systemic discrimination against people. And my claim to you is that that is unfair, even if the reason is to redress past injustices. If you want to redress past injustices, the way to do it is to truly make the school system a first-rate school system and provide everybody with fun, tasty lunches, education of the first rate, breakfast. You know, I mean, you'd really need to create the opportunities to allow people to flourish.